Generative AI is going to reinvent virtually every customer experience in virtually every industry, and it's really early days. So a good portion of the innovation will come from surprising places. So there are three things that I advise customers to do when they're crafting a strategy around generative AI that delivers value to their business. The first thing is to think much bigger than how they're thinking about things right now and to have an open mind, because this is really the time to think big.
Automation Anywhere is an automation company. And so we see ourselves as an automation company. And our big focus is on infusing generative AI into the automation success platform and driving business outcomes.
So our Genesys Cloud platform is an AI-first experience orchestration platform that allows for customers to deliver customer experiences, employee experiences, and ultimately business outcomes that work for their mission and their goals as an organization.
Today, one of the fundamental problems is that data is siloed. When it's siloed, you're not seeing the full picture of it. So when we bring the power of Salesforce Data Cloud, the power that we bring is that they can leave the data where it is, but they can reference the data as though it's natively available within Salesforce Data Cloud. And all the rest of the operations that you can do, whether it's training AI models, whether it is harmonizing it and seeing it as a single point of view, single view of the customer, all of that is possible in by leaving the data where it is.
The second thing is to hold fast to time-tested business and technology principles. The use cases for generative AI invariably rest on those existing tenets. They involve bringing together today's technologies and applications with new capabilities and features that are built on generative AI. And just as with other technologies, you'll get more value by improving data posture, by migrating and modernizing legacy applications, by adopting cloud-based microservices and APIs, and you can absolutely improve outcomes by improving your enterprise-wide technology capabilities.
With Bedrock and SageMaker, not only do you have a plethora of large language models, especially a lot of these startups that really are moving fast in terms of building these large language models, but it's not only about proprietary models, but also the open source models. So different use cases might require different models. And having that choice where you can use different models, even the same automation workflow for different steps, is hugely beneficial to our customers.
When we think about the diversity of models in the landscape, what we want to do is really test the efficacy for the specific use cases that we're adopting. And we have experiences that all models will likely supply good results for. So something like knowledge delivery and answer delivery, most of the models in the market do a decent job with that. But then when you approach a different problem, like the ability to do that in many different popular languages around the world for which we have regional needs. When we think about that, not all the models are created equal. And the investment in the ability to do things multi-language and also multi-mode, thinking about image and beyond text content, we really need that diversity in the landscape to come through. And we love the Bedrock offer for its ability to give us entree into that with a consistent interface.
The third thing is to be realistic about where you are in your journey. So start where you are. There are certainly quick wins to be had along the way, so build adoption strategies that deliver incremental value en route to deeper transformation. Don't wait for everything to be perfect before you get started.
I think that the idea of being agile, to be able to change your product plans on a dime, to respond to new developments is really important. I think that we really expect that not only will we be measured in terms of our ability to deliver a finished application that really works well for a use case, but we're also going to be judged on the basis of how well we execute in actually creating those things.
How do you measure the success of generative AI? So in the world of automation, it's all about outcomes. And those outcomes really depend on your use case, right? So if you're in the contact center, is it going to improve agent productivity? Is it going to reduce average handling time?
For a salesperson, it's the number of emails that you're able to respond to in how quickly were you able to respond to them. And the quality of the responses is also can be measured. You could also look at metrics like how long did it take to write a case wrap-up summary. The case wrap-up summary time reduction has gone from, let's say, 45 to 5, and that's a significant improvement in productivity and how the agent's time gets utilized.
We expect as much as a 70% increase in business productivity with the power of automation generative AI. And on the flip side, we see a 55% improvement in developer productivity to build these automations. We're seeing hundreds of customers deploy both POCs as well as live deployments of automation and generative AI. There are three key use cases we're seeing. One is around customer service. So think about service operations, call centers, service help desks. The second big use case is around supply chain, and especially around document processing. And the third big use case is around employee experience, because ultimately, the power of generative AI is really human augmentation, really helping employees do more, do better, and drive business value.
So every workflow, every employee experience, and every customer experience is going to be transformed. And really, the shifts in the economy are really just starting, right? The role of workers will change from delivering service directly to working alongside of AI. Our relationship to content and to the types of interfaces that we're used to using as we do our work will change. And I'm really expecting to see a vastly changed landscape in 10 years or so.
And that's why we have over 100,000 customers of all sizes and industries that are leveraging AWS AI and machine learning services. These users are getting more productive and their work is getting more valuable.